Turn number four, she'll take the green this time. So far, Jessica Zemkin coming off an 8th place finish on Autodrome Granby and a 13th place finish on Tuesday up at Autodrome Drummond. So 8th and a 13th, her best finish on the season here in the Eastern Region is an 8th. First time by for Jay-Z. Stops the clock. One, three, four, two, six, the first lap for Jessica Zemkin. Second lap. 1:34.78. So her first lap, 1:34.26, the quick time. Car competition. Barger has made one attempt to qualify here in the Eastern Region. That came down at the Fonda Speedway on June the 8th. He finished in 6th. So now he'll take the green. A look to set quick time here. Again, time to beat 13:4.26, set by Jessica Zemkin on her opening lap as Barger works it down on the bottom off the top side here off of turn number 4. One, three, six, one, one, the first lap for Justin Barger. So Jessica Zemkin, still quick time, 13:4.26. Second time by for Justin Barger. Improved, but not enough. Jay-Z, still quick time, 1:35.30, the second lap for Justin Barger. Mark Ide in the number 87X. He'll work it off of turn 4. He'll take the green this time. He attempted to qualify earlier in the season down at the Clinton County Raceway with that number 87X. Tight quarter-mile racetrack, as I mentioned. And he'll work it off of turn number 4. First time around for Mark Ide. His time, 1:4.757. 1:4.757. First lap for Mark Ide. Second lap on the clock. 1:5.007 for her, so his first lap will be quicker, 1:4.757. So Mark Ide's time, Pennsylvania, and he'll bring it off the turn, taking the green flag this time around. We'll see if he can unseat Jessica Zemkin. 1:3.426, the time to beat, as he works it off the top side of turn number 2, down the long backstretch into corners number 3 and 4, predominantly on the cushion. We'll see if that bodes well for him. He'll stop the clock here first time. 3rd quick, 1:3.545 for Danny Holtgraver. Now he'll bring it off the turn, hoping to improve it upon that. Needs about a tenth of a second. 2nd quick, 1:3.511. 1:3.511 for Danny Holtgraver. Motorsports 83, the Steel City Outlaw, Tim Schaefer. Tim Schaefer in car number 83. He'll take the green, and he has got his own line going way up there on the top side. Up turns 1 and 2. He'll make his way down the back straightaway. Now he'll take it down into corners number 3 and 4. He'll look for the white flag this time around. And he will stop the clock. 1:3.574. 1:3.574 for Tim Schaefer. And we have a new fast time, 1:3.365, the second lap for Tim Schaefer. He is now quick time. That moves Jessica Zemkin back to the second spot. Now on machine, it's Stevie Smith. Stevie Smith, car number 1. He'll roll the outside here down the front straightaway. Green coming out for him. He'll take it up to the outside of turn number 2, work it down the back straightaway. Again, looking to beat 1:3.365, set by Tim Schaefer. First time by for Stevie Smith. 1:3.602, so about 3/10 off is Stevie Smith working on the cushion off of turn 4. Can he better that time? 1:3.463 for Stevie Smith. That puts him third quick right now for management. Advanced Development Service, Cocockton Motorsports, car number 30C out of Fayetteville, Pennsylvania, Lance DeWeese. Lance DeWeese in car number 30C. He'll take it up to the top side in turn number 1. Everybody else working that high side as well. Let's see what he's got. He'll take it down the backstretch. Again, the time to beat Tim Schaefer, 1:3.365 off of turn number 4. First time around for Lance DeWeese. 1-3-4-6-6. The first time for Lance DeWeese. That is fourth quick as he comes off of turn four, looking to improve by about a tenth of a second. Unfortunately for DeWeese, he went the other way. 1-3-5-3-8. 1-3-5-3-8. Now the guy chasing him in the point standings. He is out of Owosso, Oklahoma, in the Lelands.com. Hefner Racing, car number 27. He's coming off two wins in a row. He'll come off of turn number four. This is Darren Pittman. Darren Pittman, he'll take the green flag here on the home stretch. Pittman, again, two wins this week. Autodrome Granby, Autodrome Drummond, also won a week ago down at the Bedford Speedway in Pennsylvania. He'll make his way off of turn number four. Let's see if he can top Schaefer's time. 1-3-5-6-2. 1-3-5-6-2 for Darren Pittman off of turn four for his second lap. A tick slower, 1-3-5-7-8. 1-3-5-7-8 on his second lap. Now getting underway, driver out of Clark Summit, Pennsylvania. Again, the First Aid Auto, Donat Racing Engines. Car number 87, it's George Suprick III. George Suprick in that number 87 machine getting underway. And Suprick competing at the Fonda Speedway as well as the Granby. And Drummond, his best finish here in the Eastern region so far, a 12th place finish on Tuesday at Autodrome Drummond. So right now he is on the clock, making his way down the backstretch into turns number three and four. We'll see where Suprick stops the clock here as he comes on by. One 4-2-1-7 for George Suprick's first lap, and he'll make his way off of turn four to complete lap number two. About 0.3 quicker that time, 1-3-9-8-2, 1-3-9-8-2 for George Suprick. So again, right now your quick timer is still Tim Schaefer, 1-3-3-6-5. That is the time to beat. And now coming out onto the racetrack, this is drive out of Beaumont, Pennsylvania, the EIO Waste Solutions, Black Mountain Coal, Australia Racing Engines, car number 2i of Clint Ide. Clint Ide in car number 2i. He is on the clock now. He'll take it up off the back straight away, working the inside lane that time over through turns one and two. Now he'll work it through the middle off of corners number three and four. He will stop the clock this time by. One 5-3-6-9. 1-5-3-6-9 for Mark Ide. So now his final lap, he brings it down off the turn to the checkered flag. One 5-2-6-7, second lap for Clint Ide. That was about a tenth quicker for his second lap. All right, pushing off now, driving out of Watertown, Connecticut, in the JRC Transportation, IGA Foods, Modelcraft, car number 89, it is David Gravel. David Gravel now out on the racetrack. He'll make his way off of turn number four. And Gravel coming off a second place finish at Autodrome Drummond and a third place finish up at Autodrome Granby. Still looking for his first win here in the Eastern region. He'll bring his way off of corner number four down to the line here with the 89G. Quick time, 1-3-2-8-7, fast time. Now for David Gravel, 1-3-2-8-7, second lap. A little bit slower, 1-3-4-6-0, but the one that matters, 1-3-2-8-7 for the number 89J, David Gravel. So he is right now, he is your quick timer. Coming out onto the racetrack, driver's turned a lot of laps here at the Mohawk International Raceway. He is from Fairfax, Vermont, in the Lock Lane Masonry, Cobble Hill Trailer Sales, Casella Waste Management. Car number 15C, the A-Train, Anthony Kane. Anthony Kane making the jump. The 410 sprint car competition here. Again, had motor trouble with his 360, so they got the 410 together, and he ran the last couple events up at Autodrome Granby and Drummond. Down the backstretch he'll go. A pair of 11th place finishes for Anthony Kane. He'll stop the clock first time by. 1-4-0-0-8, the first lap for Anthony Kane. 1-4-0-0-8 for Anthony Kane. one more time. He'll bring it off of turn four. A little bit of a bobble over there in corners, number three and four. A little bit slower that time, but not much. 1-4-0-5-6. 1-4-0-5-6 for Anthony Kane. So four cars left to come to the track for time trials. Can anybody beat David Gravel? 1-3-2-8-7 as he looks to set fast time here in Kissel Racing Engines qualifying. Down the back straight right now, driving out of Bellevue, Ohio in the Henry Motorsports 83H. This is Cap Henry. Cap Henry, again, had a trailer accident, and that's why you see the car pieced together here this evening. Down the back straightaway goes Cap Henry. One to go this time by. And caution coming out on the racetrack. So issue with the scoring down here on the racetrack. So that's why back on the clock here. Cap Henry makes his way off of turn four. He'll get the green and trip the timer, and we're underway. So he'll take it off of turn two, down the long back straightaway. Swing it into turn three and four. Again, he is electing to run the high side as well. Brings it off of turn number four, first time for Cap Henry. 1-3-5-5-4, first lap for Cap Henry. He'll try it again, try to improve upon that. Off the corner, checkered flag, Cap Henry's second lap. 1-3-6-9-5, his second lap, so first lap quickest. 1-3-5-5-4, still about 3/10 off David Gravel's quick time of 1-3-2-8-7. All right, pushing off now. Driving out of Hartford, Ohio in the TI 22 Performance, former three-time Raleigh Auto Parts All-Star Circuit of Champions Series champion. This is Dale Blaney. Dale Blaney working it down now off of corner number four. He'll take the green, and he is on the clock. Blaney coming off a sixth-place finish at Autodrome Drummond and a second place up at Autodrome Granby. Also had a second place at Port Royal here in 2011 in the Eastern Region. Off the turn, lap number one. 1-3-4-2-0. 1-3-4-2-0, first time. Again, he comes in as well as the overall series point leader. Now working his way off of turn number four, checkered flag. 1-3-4-4-0. 1-3-4-4-0. That is third quick. Third quick now for Dale Blaney. So third quick for Dale Blaney. Quick time. Still David Gravel. 1-3-2-8-7. Out onto the racetrack, making his debut here with the Raleigh Auto Parts All-Star Circuit of Champions from nearby Cornwall, Ontario, and the Olson Fab Fabrications, Pat Carone Heating and Air Conditioning. Car number 24K, that's Devin Carone. Devin Carone out there with the number 24K. Again, this is his debut here with the All-Stars down into turn number three. He'll work it down into corner number four and bring it off the turn. First time by four, Devin Carone. 1-4-9-4-5. 1-4-9-4-5 for Devin Carone. One more time now off of corner number four, second lap. Took nearly a half second off. 1-4-4-3-6. 1-4-4-3-6 for Devin Carone. Last car out for time trials. Rolling out onto the racetrack. Again, he's out of Portview, Pennsylvania in the American Recovery. Sponsored car number three, Pete Miller III. Pete Miller III out there on the racetrack now. He'll take the green this time by taking a look at Miller. He had a 10th place finish on Tuesday at Drummond and a 15th at Autodrome Granby. His best finish so far here in the Eastern Region, a 12th place finish down at the Fonda Speedway on June the 8th. He'll swing it off the turn, come down the line, complete his first time around. First lap for Pete Miller, 1-4-4-9-9, 1-4-4-9-9 for Pete Miller III. Have to improve on that one off of corner number four. Second lap, let's see if he can get a better time. 1:04.119. So 3/10 quicker for Pete Miller. 1:04.119. So that concludes Kissel Racing Engines.
27 with Dylan Evoy, four times a winner, and the winner of the last three in a row here at Mohawk in that 83. We're back underway. Green flag is in the air. And Anderson and Jackson battle side by side down the back straightaway as the field works into turns three and four. It's Jackson on the bottom, Anderson on the top side. Travis back trying to find a hole. There comes Dylan Evoy, though, from the back of the field, Brian, and starting to make some headway early.
Evoy looking for a spot on the inside, not able to get around the 18 of Louis Jackson Jr. Louis Jackson Jr. holding the bottom as they head into turns three and four. Evoy now going to try the high side as the battle up front continues between Thunder Anderson and the number one of Travis Back.
And Evoy does go upstairs to his office on the top side of the speedway and goes to that third position, moving Jackson back to the number four spot. Hogarth completes the top five up in front. Travis Back putting on a show here so far, nearly going. He leads the way by about four car lengths. Then that battle for second.
Well, it could not have hurt Travis Back's driving experience whatsoever by trying to qualify in Cornwall with a big block on last Sunday night. Travis Back continues to lead. Is the 83 of Dylan Evoy in second, and in third is the 30X of Thunder Anderson.
As your field works down the back straightaway this time, Travis Back has the top spot all to himself. Travis has yet to claim a heat win here in 2011, but he'd like to change that right now. Dylan Evoy has two of them. Off turns three and four, they work. It's Travis Back, Dylan Evoy. Thunder Anderson continues a strong run in third.
Well, the competition tonight looking for to break the winning streak of Dylan Evoy, as he has three out of the last 4 weeks. The only one that's been able to beat him so far this season in the last month is Mother Nature.
Absolutely. Tommy Conklin and Sheldon Hogarth, the only other winners this year in the Sportsman Division, and Hogarth working on Anderson for that third spot. Two more laps remain here in this eight-lap heat event for the Sportsmen as they head through turns three and four. Travis Back right there in that number one spot, drifts up off the bottom in turn number four with Dylan Evoy chasing him at the white flag lap.
This track will continue to be heavy and tacky this evening as the 410 sprints are able to pack down the high side. Tim, I think later on the race for these open-wheeled cars, you're going to see some passing on the high side as the racetrack continues to come in.
Checkered flag flies, and Travis Back will get his first heat win of the season. Dylan Evoy second. Hogarth comes up the third. Anderson Jackson back once again here at Mohawk. Ryan Arbuthnot in the M1. Complete your field. Green flag is out. Jenna David grabs the early lead.
It'll be Jenna David on the early lead as she'll dip to the bottom and turns one and two. Behind her, some heavy traffic, as sitting in the second spot will be the number 76 of Christian Smoke in the inside position. The 03 of Josh Jock now takes over second.
And Jock does have that number two spot right now with the 76 of Smoke right behind him. Jock drifted up the racetrack off of turn two and got a great run that time down the back straightaway. He'll hold off Smoke for the time being. Then it's Brent Kelsey, Brandon Hagen, and Ryan Arbuthnot. Meanwhile, Jenna David doing a pretty good job for herself as she leads the field in lap number two.
Well, Jenna David, as you mentioned, Tim, was involved in a race incident at Rolling Wheels. Now is coming up behind her is the machine of 03, Josh Jock, looking for something on the inside. Jenna David says, nope, I'm going to slam the door.
And she works off of corners three and four. Now Josh Jock sees daylight down to the inside, and David works the middle groove of the racetrack and is able to hold Jock off for the time being, as now David pulls away down the back straightaway. Christian Smoke in that third spot in the 76 had the wheels alongside of Jock, but Josh Jock decided to pull away and try to chase down Jenna David at the halfway point. Four in and four to go.
As you see, Josh Jock trying to go to the low side now, coming out of two. He will make the pass, and he will get the lead from the two of Jenna David. In third, it is the 76X of Christian Smoke.
And Jock does have the top spot as it comes up off of corners three and four. Three car lengths the distance between himself and Jenna David. It's Christian Smoke back there third. Hagen has gotten around the 30 of Kelsey to take fourth. Kelsey relegated to fifth. Ryan Arbuthnot rounds out your field in the M1. As right now, your leader, Josh Jock, has all but checked out on everybody. He's got two laps. Austin Swamp says, you got a great big lead out there. You can just kind of take your time with two more to go.
The double sticks for the 03 of Josh Jock as he continues to lead. creating a little more space for himself as he turns into turns 3 and 4, making the pass on the inside and collecting. Jenna David is the 76 of Christian Smoke. Also involved in that is the 30 machine of Brent Kelsey. Tough break for those three racers right there, Tim.
And it's going to be a long night for all three drivers over there. Of course, Brent Kelsey, as I mentioned, reigning dirt car sportsman out as well. Race time, as always, 7 p.m. Sportsman set to get back underway, Brian.
It'll be Josh Jock seeing the green hanky from Austin Swamp. Now with 7 in the books, looking to complete 8 here. Josh Jock is your leader, followed by the number 12 of Brendan Hagen, the number 1 of Travis Back, and rounding out the field is the number 2 of Jenna David as Jock continues to lead coming out of 4.
Checkered flag is out, and Josh Jock will pick up the win.
Second spot. It'll be Mike Arquette, your early race leader, as the green flag is displayed by Austin Swamp. In second, it is the 74 of Neil Provo. Sitting in the third spot is the M70 of Billy Cook. Dylan Swallows in the number 11 car. Mike Arquette, you still your race leader. And I must mention that is Josh Jock's first ever career heat win. And unless I'm mistaken, Tim, I do believe that is his first career heat win.
I believe it is his first heat win in a sportsman car. And it definitely is his first heat win of the year. But right now, Mike Arquette is making things look very easy. Of course, Mike is a graduate of the Pro Stock division here. He struggled mightily in the Pro Stocks, got into the sportsman car, and it's just like night and day for him. He has come right to life right now, sitting in the top 5 of the point standing as well, which you can check out back behind the grandstands at the restroom facilities. As we work off turns 3 and 4, it's Arquette, your leader.
Mike Arquette, continuing his strong run here this season at the Mohawk International Raceway. As you mentioned, Tim, he is up there in points. Why? He finishes consistently. He finishes in the top 7 every week. That's why he is where he is in the point standings as he continues to lead, followed by Neil Provost and the 29 car of Tom Conklin, now starting to make up some real estate.
4 laps left to go here as we're halfway through this third and final heat for the Frenchies Built Ford Tough Sportsman Division. And Mike Arquette does have the top spot. Neil Provost is starting to come to life as well. He rides in second. Then it's Tommy Conklin third, Tom Benedict, Billy Cook, and Dylan Sallows.
Well, now there's 5 in the books coming out of turns 2, it is Mike Arquette continues to lead now, creating a little more distance between him and the second place car of Neil Provost. And as we mentioned, Tom Conklin now going to look to the inside, and he's going to make the pass on Neil Provost as they come around to complete lap number 6.
With 2 more laps remaining, Conklin making a big move out here late in this event as they work down the back straightaway into turns 3 and 4. It's Arquette on top of the field with about 4 car lengths separating himself and Tommy Conklin. White flag in the air, and I tell you what, Tommy Conklin is starting to reel him in just a little bit. He's got a little better piece than Arquette as they work the back straightaway.
Well, Tom Conklin, if he's not able to complete the pass on Mike Arquette here, he may say, I didn't lose the race, I just ran out of laps. Mike Arquette now is your leader, but Tom Conklin is going to look to the inside. Not enough.
Congratulations. The distance. Green flag will fly. Ryan Helm grabs the early lead as your field works into turns 1 and 2. Melvin Rush dips down to the inside. He'll pick off second from Derek Martin. Perry Francis trying to fill the gap on the bottom. Couldn't quite get the job done, though. Kerry Terrance is already up into the number 4 spot. He is charged from the back of the field, but Ryan Helm, the man of the hour right now, is he'll lead lap number 1.
The multi-groove racing service here at Mohawk starting to come into play. You see racers on the bottom, on the top. They're making both lanes work right now, Tim, as Perry Francis is looking on the inside coming into turns 3.
And Perry Francis has got a strong mount right there as he charged right after Ryan Helm. Had the wheels alongside of him for just a little bit. Couldn't quite complete the pass, though, as he'll settle into the number 2 spot. Melvin Rush got freight trained by Jeff Sykes and Kerry Terrance. Sykes starting to make his move forward. He gets by Terrance. Now he'll charge up underneath Perry Francis to take the runner-up spot. Francis fighting back on the top side. All this happening behind Ryan Helm as he leads lap 2.
Helm now picking up 2 rear passengers as it is the 4J of Jeff Sykes. Perry Francis on the outside completes the pass coming out of turn 2.
And I'll tell you what, that was a bold move down there. They're almost 3 wide coming out of 2. Ryan Helm was probably saying, where did they come from? But Perry Francis is leading the field now down into turns 1 and 2. It's Helm. Now Kerry Terrance sees daylight on the top side. We'll see if Jeff Sykes makes that move as well. He rides back in spot number 4. Larry Welling has come up into the top 5 as well in the 21. He rides in 5th. It's Melvin Rush and Derek Martin completing your field.
Well, you can pass low, you can pass high. Perry Francis chose to pass high coming out of turns 2. as now we see smoke coming out of the 66X machine of Carrie Trance as they head into turns 3 and 4.
And that is not valve cover smoke. There is a little bit of fire up underneath the 66 machine as the caution flag flies. You can see it right there. And track crews will attend to Carrie's 66 machine in a hurry, and they are letting him know about it over the one-way radio system. And, of course, we saw the fire up underneath the car. Not sure if Carrie saw it or not, but if he didn't see it, he probably felt it. And had a chance to talk to Carrie at Cornwall a couple of weeks ago and finally got his season on track. He was a little bit lost to start the year off. They were trying some different things, experimenting with different.
So it'll be Perry Francis taking the green from Austin. Lap 6 now underway as Jeff Sykes follows in second, followed by the 15 of Ryan Helm. But now along on the inside of Ryan Helm will be the 21 machine of Larry Welling Jr. as he turns into turns 3 and 4, looking for the bottom and trying to complete the pass.
And Welling does have a strong piece up underneath that 21 machine as he works on that number 3 spot. He clears Ryan Helm. Down the back straightaway they hustle, and it is Perry Francis still leading this field. Jeff Sykes in that number 4 machine riding back there in the second spot as Welling completes the top 3.
Well, Larry Welling Jr. looked very strong last week as he had visited us, I believe, for only the second time this season, as we've got a car, I believe that's Jeff Sykes, off of turns between turns 1 and 2.
And a tough break for Sykes, so some of the blue van with Ontario plates that is blocking the driveway, and it needs to be moved. License plate number BJYK282, BJYK282. That has to be moved immediately. Green flag is back out, and Perry Francis able to take away the number 1 spot. Ryan Hell, Melvin Rush at each other for second and third. Then it's Derek Martin back there in the fourth spot. Checkered flag will be out this time by Perry Francis. Continues his strong 2011 season of Chris Rabby. Field getting set and ready to go. We're off and running, and Tarbell is waiting for no one. He charges around Rick Miller right off the green flag, and he'll go to the top spot, bringing Clayton Benedict with him. They're 3 wide back there for fifth, and Rabby makes a nice move down to the inside. He'll take away the number 5 spot as they come off of turns 3 and 4. It is Roy Tarbell, your leader.
Chris Rabby, last week's 50-lap feature winner, starting scratch on the field due to the handicapping of points now as he continues to make his way up the field. Starting scratch, he is now into third.
And he is not done yet as Todd Stone with a problem in the 1X. He'll take it pit side. But right now, Roy Tarbell leads the field into 1 and 2. But the story right now is Chris Rabby. He started 7th on the grid and in 2 laps has made his way up to the number 3 spot. And he's not done there. He's going to charge up underneath Clayton Benedict to try to take away the second spot. Meanwhile, Tarbell continues to set the pace.
Roy Tarbell hoping that the 12 of Clayton Benedict could hold off the hard charging of the 01 of Chris Rabby, unable to do so as Rabby found the inside lane, and now he's staring down the back bumper of the 007 of Roy Tarbell.
As they come off of turns 3 and 4, Tarbell a little bit loose off of turn number 4. Rabby is right there with him. As Rabby tried the inside move, couldn't quite get it done that time. He'll fall in behind the 007 of Tarbell as they work into turns 3 and 4. Tarbell, once again, very loose, coming off of turn 4. And Rabby gets down to the inside, finds some bite at the halfway point. He goes to the lead.
Well, now we're seeing the track, the inside, starting to come together a little bit better than the top side as Roy Tarbell, a little out of shape coming out of 2. And in 3rd, it is the 12 of Clayton Benedict. In 4th now, Gage Moran, who's starting to make his way up through the field.
And Moran right there at position number 4, as you mentioned, celebrated his 19th birthday this past Monday. And in his 3rd year of modified racing, that is just something extraordinary right there. And a feature winner to boot here at Mohawk International Raceway. But right now, Chris Rabby, who is no stranger to victory lane here, leads at lap number 7.
As you mentioned, Gage Moran just turned 19, and the funny part is Mike Mallett is wearing a shirt older than Gage tonight as he's joined us up in the booth for the O'Reilly 410 Sprints, as their feature is coming up later this evening.
Field working down the back straightaway, and Chris Rabby is just a man possessed out there. A full straightaway advantage back to the runner-up, Roy Tarbell. But right now, Gage Moran is closing quickly on the 007 at the white flag lap. Once again, Roy Tarbell's machine looks very loose out there, and you can definitely see not able to hook it up off the corner. And Gage Moran's going to drag race him into turns 3 and 4. But it's Rabby, your winner, at the checkered flag.
Coming around to collect the second position will be the 16 of Gage Moran, the 007 of Roy Tarbell, and third, the 12 of Clayton Benedict. And fourth, and rounding out the field is the issue here.
Field working off of turns three and four. Casey Swamp on the gas first. He'll lead him into turns one and two. As Lazor was able to get by Gardner Stone to pick up the second spot, Timmy O'Brien's going to follow him right there in third. It's Stone in fourth, followed by Kevin Gamble. Mario Clare, the 2008 Mr. Dirt Car 358 Modified Champion, joining us once again. Of course, his brother Gino Clare was with us last week. So Mario trying to fine-tune his machine. Of course, they got a big series race coming up in September, so he's looking to get a little bit of an edge on the field as Casey Swamp works his way into turns three and four with the top spot. John Lazor right there behind him, but he's got Timmy O'Brien to his inside.
I had a chance to talk to Casey Swamp earlier this afternoon, if you will. One thing he had mentioned to me that he really missed the gears set up for last week's feature. He felt bad. He said he's going to get it back together and continue to work hard, as he's doing as he continues to lead this heat number three.
And I tell you what, we got a great battle going on for the number two spot, as O'Brien and Lazor have traded that position probably three or four times in the last two laps here, but O'Brien does sneak on by to get that number two spot from Lazor. John takes it up to the top side of the speedway, using that cushion to his advantage, but O'Brien stays strong on the bottom, but Swamp, still the man in the hour, he leads lap number four.
Swamp now going to have some company inside. Timmy O'Brien's going to look to the bottom. Casey Swamp says, no, I don't think so, but on the outside, John Lazor coming into three. Three wide as we go into three and four.
And I'll tell you what, they're not done yet. O'Brien on the bottom. Lazor in the middle, wisely backing out as that gap between O'Brien and Swamp started to narrow. And right now, Timmy O'Brien has the top spot as they work down the back straightaway. Now Lazor puts his foot down. He goes to the number two spot. Casey Swamp is third. Gardner Stone and Kevin Gamble, your top five, as Mario Clare completes the field.
Timmy O'Brien able to erase some of the gremlins he had earlier in the season here. Tim, with a broken motor, I believe, 2 weeks in a row, he went to the backup car of John Lazor. And now the youngster out of Kingston, Ontario, has got his machine back together, leading heat race number three.
That Jim's Performance Plus number 88 machine stuck right down to the inside part of the speedway, and he'll lead the field down the back stretch into turns three and four. John Lazor about seven car lengths back, then a gap of about four back to Casey Swamp, with Gardner Stone in fourth, Kevin Gamble and Mario Clare.
Two laps now to go. It is the 88 of Timmy O'Brien, followed by the 19 of John Lazor, who's trying to gain some precious real estate as they head into turns three and four. Casey Swamp rides along in the third position, and in the fourth position as the white flag, one to go, is Gardner Stone and the X1 machine. Timmy O'Brien continues to lead on the backstretch.
And John Lazor trying to run him down, but he's going to run out of time and run out of laps. Checkered flag is out, and O'Brien will collect the win. Lazor will get the number two spot. Casey Swamp, Gardner Stone, Kevin four. Gamble.
Right there by the cone. Here they come off of turn number four. Suprick, Henry on the gas, and we are green here on the front straightaway. Up in the corners, number one and two, and it will be Cap Henry jumping the end. Look at Stevie Smith on the outside. Smith bolts to the top side. He moves up to position number two, and now David Gravel grabs the number three spot away. Off the corner, first time around, it is Cap Henry leading the way. Stevie Smith in the number two spot. Third right now is David Gravel. Fourth now, Danny Holdgraver. But he just looked to his left. He saw Dale Blaney down on the inside. Down the back straightaway, though, race. About two car lengths separating position number four on the racetrack. Holdgraver going to go to the outside. Blaney going to try to go down low off of turn number four. That's not going to get it done, as Holdgraver able to hold him off right now for position number four. Along the back straightaway, Blaney trying to close in on Holdgraver. They'll race up into corners number three and four. Your leader off the turn. Three laps complete this time by. Continues to be Cap Henry. Second, Stevie Smith. Third is David Gravel. Fourth is still Holdgraver. Fifth is Blaney. Sixth is Suprick. Seventh is Miller. And eighth right now is the Eyed number 87X. This time we'll cross him over halfway. Four in, four to go. Four, Cap Henry, driver out of Ohio, looking to work down the back stretch and hold off Stevie Smith. And now Smith going to feel some pressure here momentarily as David Gravel worked the inside through one and two. Made up some ground. Now he'll work down low off of corner number four. Can't quite get it done. Can't make that pass for position. Down the back stretch, Cap Henry now going to work to the outside of the number 87X of Ide as they take it up into turn number three. Stevie Smith to the outside as well. And now Gravel works the top side with two laps remaining. So two to go. Holdgraver side by side with Blaney as they race for position number four. And now Blaney's got it up on the top side. And Blaney now into position number four down the back straightaway. Off of corner number four comes your leader, and hopefully your winner here in a lap, if he can hang on. That's Cap Henry. Henry down to the inside, working it off of turn number two. One more time down the back straightaway. He'll take it up into turns number 3 and 4. And picking up the win will be the 83H. That is Cap Henry. Coming home in the number 2 spot, Stevie Smith. Third to the 89G of David Gravel. Fourth to the 2 of Dale Blaney. And fifth to the D4 of Danny Holtgraver. Sixth to the 87X. Pittman up on the outside, coming off a third in Pennsylvania Speed Week point standings. Off the turn now. Look for the green. They got it, and we are racing here down the front straightaway. Pittman side by side with Anthony Kane up into turn number 1. It will be Pittman bolting by on the outside. Lance DeWeese going 3 wide down the back straightaway. DeWeese looked to get by Barger. Barger slams the door. Now Schaefer spins to the inside. Schaefer now to the inside of DeWeese off of corner number 4. Can't get that done, but now he'll dive down low going up into turn number 1 on Kane, and he is now up to third. Down the back straightaway, Barger's got the number 2 spot, but Tim Schaefer closing in. Schaefer drives right on by Barger, getting into turn number 3, and he'll grab the number 2 spot. Your race leader, Darren Pittman. Schaefer now second. Barger there for third. Kane up to the number 4 spot. Now Lance DeWeese side by side with Kane off of turn number 2, but Kane holds him off down the back stretch of the race into corners number 3 and 4. Lance DeWeese now looks to the inside as Kane drifts high off of corner number 4. Wing to wing, they come down to the start finish line with 3 laps complete. And Lance DeWeese now going to complete the pass of Anthony Kane. He drifts up. Kane now falls back to position number 5 here in the running order. Halfway this time by Darren Pittman. He is gone, setting sail now over Tim Schaefer. Third on the grid, Justin Barger. Fourth is Lance DeWeese. And fifth is now Jessica Zemkin. That puts Anthony Kane back to the number 6 spot. Seventh on the speedway is Devin Carone. And eighth right now is the 2i of Clint Ide. That's the way they run with 5 laps complete along the backstretch. Ide going to go 1 lap down to your race leader, Darren Pittman. Again, driver out of Owasso, Oklahoma, the Leland's.com. Number 27 bringing it off of turn number 4. He has got 2 laps to go. Schaefer, he is making track. Started back in position number 6. He is now in a qualifying position, working it off the bottom off of turn 2. Down the backstretch, trying to close in on Pittman, but Pittman is gone. White flag down for Darren Pittman. So Pittman taking it up into turn number 1 and 2 one more time. He'll take it off the corner and head down the back straightaway. He's closing in on Devin Carone as they race through turns number 3 and 4. Checkered flag this time, picking up the victory. It will be Darren Pittman. Finishing in second will be Tim Schaefer. Third will go to Lance DeWeese. Fourth to Justin Barger. Fifth to Jessica Zemkin. And sixth goes to Anthony Kane.
Of course, seventh will Jill be Goddard, former feature winner here many times over. Of course, he had a feature locked up at Cornwall a couple weeks ago and sadly lost a motor with 2 laps to go. But he's back here and glad to see him here with us tonight. As the green flag is out, Jody Swamp, a man who literally caught fire here last Friday night, but he's back here and looking in fine form right now as he leads the parade off of turn number 4 with Ricky Thompson and LeBrun giving chase.
Little rubber laid down by the 410 sprints, the methanol burning sprint cars. Jody Swamp continues to lead Ricky Thompson in second. Now he's going to have a little company on the inside of him, as it'll be the 6 of Stefan LeBrun. In fourth, it is Rod Tarbell, as Ricky Thompson has a problem with his car, and Gilles Goddard, and a victim of unfortunate circumstances there, as Ricky Thompson.
Speedway, regular racing program, all 5 divisions on the card as well. Modified, sportsman, pro stocks, semi-pros, and the 4-cylinder mini stock division.
2 laps in the books as Jody Swamp takes the green flag, continues to lead the field now of 6 cars. 6 laps is the issue. Deion Oaks will make the move on the inside, passing Stefan LeBrun. LeBrun now going to drop to the bottom side, looking to get back that position and unable to do so. Coming around in fourth is the 73 of P.J. Peters.
And Swamp does have the top spot. He's going to work to the outside part of the speedway this time as Deion Oaks in that 48 machine. Working down into turns 3 and 4 with the lead, but Deion Oaks is able to make a move down to the inside, and Brian, he'll go up to the number 1 spot.
Jody Swamp likes the high side, going to try to make a move here on the high side, coming out of 2 and unable to do so, as Deion Oaks will lead him coming into 3 and 4. Some company as Stefan LeBrun now has moved up to the rear bumper of Jody Swamp.
And meanwhile, up on the back straightaway, Preston Musau in the 102 will head pit side. But up in front, Deion Oaks continues to set the pace, and Jody Swamp, despite being right there with him, has got some company now in the form of Stefan LeBrun. LeBrun, the 2008 track champion here, along with P.J. Peters in the 73. Rod Tarbell completes the top 5 with 2 to go.
Nice to see P.J. Peters back with us here this Thursday evening as we welcome the O'Reilly Super Sprints. the 410 methanol burning machines. Deion Oaks is your leader as they come into turns 3 and 4 as Jody Swamp now starting to gain a little real estate on Deion Oaks. Going to try to peek to the inside. Deion Oaks says, I don't think so. One lap to go.
And Deion Oaks has been absent with us for about 3 weeks or so, but we're glad to have him back, and he looks like he might be able to contend for a heat win so far tonight as Jody Swamp closes the turns 3 and 4. Stefan LeBrun right there behind him in third, but it's going to be Deion Oaks collecting the win. Jody Swamp, Stefan LeBrun, your top three. Then it's P.J. Peters, Rod Tarbell, and Ricky Thompson's going to make it back
Greg
out.
Greg Revelle, our webmaster, and, of course, got to get up and go to work in the morning, sadly. But, hey, you know, that's life.
I feel your pain as Dave the Bulldog Bizanet leads the field now. As behind him, they're starting to tighten up, coming into 3 and 4, Tim, as we've got one car going into the wall between turns 3 and 4.
And I believe that is the 47X of this year at Lincoln and Lima, respectively. So those are just some of the feature winners in their season as we get back under green, finally, for this Pro Stock Heat event.
Dave the Bulldog Bizanet choosing the high side as he is your race leader. Rock O'Ban in second now as the Bulldog's going to power his way out of turn two. But Rock O'Ban says, do you smell what I'm cooking as we come into turns 3 and 4?
And Bizanet knows this speedway very well. A many-time track champion in the semi-pro late model and now pro stock division. As they work down the front stretch into turns 1 and 2, O'Ban down on the bottom, right in the thick of the battle for the track championship as well. David Papineau, your newest feature winner in the pro stocks, he rides in third. Then it's Louis Jackson fourth. Joey Lannister trying to battle up underneath of Mark Lalonde to take away the number 5 spot, but a good battle going on for the top spot.
Nothing finer than two well-built pro stocks racing side-by-side, lap after lap, as it is the 4 of Rock O'Ban on the inside, the 47 of Dave the Bulldog Bizanet on the high side. Behind them, they're stacked up. It is the 18 of Louis Jackson now. He's caught the 188 of Papineau as they come out of turn 4 to collect the halfway mark.
Louis Jackson is third, but here comes Joey Lannister. He started in the back of this field and now crawls his way up to position number 4. Albeit for a moment, though, as Papineau battling back from the top side, but still, the battle for the lead rages on up here. As Jackson a little out of shape in turn number 4. That's going to allow Lannister to pick up 2 spots in one corner.
Lannister now going to look to run down the 4 machine of Rock O'Ban as Dave the Bulldog Bizanet as they continue to battle. O'Ban able to find a little more real estate on the bottom, but here comes the Bulldog back on the high side. Joey Lannister rides in third, looking to pick up a heat win here this evening, as now we have the double sticks as Austin will display them. Still on the inside is the 4 of Rock O'Ban, and on the outside the 47 of Dave Bizanet.
And O'Ban has 2 heat wins this season. Dave Bizanet has one of them. That came last week, and he slides a little bit high. White flag in the air. Here comes Joey Lannister down on the inside. He's going to try to take second, but Bizanet, the veteran, working that top side of the speedway off of turn 2. All this happening behind your leader, Rock O'Ban, as they head through turns 3 and 4 for the final time. Bizanet finds some bite in the middle of the speedway. Checkered flag flies, and O'Ban will get the win.
In the number 5 machine. Glad to see Trevor with us, a regular runner at Cornwall. He actually made an appearance last week at Brockville, too.
Off turn 4, they hustle. Green flag is in the air. 6 laps the distance for our Bandit qualifying heat.
Last week's feature winner, the 18 of Ernie Cree now. Started 3 back in the field, now looking to make his way up as he gets past the number 8 of Randy Whiting. Number 1 of Nolan Swamp continues to lead. Behind him, the 28 of Corey Castell. As the battle on the field now is the 22 and the 79 of Derek Colbert.
Almost 3 wide. Well, now we're going to try 3 wide into turns 1 and 2, and John Green will take that number 2 spot away. Derek Colbert down on the inside along with Corey Castell. Owen White trying to move up through this field as well, and here comes Ernie Cree as a battle for the top spot rages on. Nolan Swamp has the position, but Derek Colbert right there with him off of 4.
Some very strong cars now in the top 6 positions as your leader Nolan Swamp will take the high side. Looking on the bottom is the 79 of Derek Colbert as he slips up a little bit coming out of 2, and the ON of Owen White continues to gain some real estate.
And John Green right there behind him in 4th. Ernie Cree completes the top 5, but up in front, Nolan Swamp continues to set the pace. Halfway sign is out, 3 and 3 more to go, and Swamp
Looking pretty strong here in the early going, but Derek Colbert not letting him get away. He's right there with him down the backstretch. Then it's Owen White, John Green. Ernie Cree puts his foot down. He goes by Green and in the process tries to get by White for the third spot, but back up front to the leaders, Brian Page. It's a dead heat at the line.
The one machine of Nolan Swamp, N79 of Derek Colbert, continues the battle. Double stick says Austin Swamp now as they continue. It is the 79 of Colbert on the inside, looking to take the lead as they come into 3 and 4.
And Derek Colbert down on the inside. He's going to slide up in front of Nolan Swamp off of turn number 4, and he will do so. A white flag is in the air. Swamp trying to get back at him in turns 1 and 2. Ernie Cree sees some daylight up underneath Owen White, and he'll try to take away that number 3 spot, but a good battle for those top 4 spots as John Green watching from this from 5th. Checkered flag will be out this time. Brian Colbert looks like he's got it good.
Coming out of 4, Nolan Swamp going to look to the inside. He's going to run out of track. It'll be the 79 of Derek Colbert. He will collect tonight's heat race for the Bandit Division. With that, Tim, we are going to
as they come down into turn number 3, they'll be looking to fire this time off of turn number 4. Again, the end of the wall and the Uke tire with the cone in it on the inside. That's where they can fire here off of turn number 4. Right about there. We're green and we are underway. And Stevie Smith going to look to the outside. Gravel down on the inside, side by side through turns number 1 and 2. And Stevie Smith with the edge down the backstretch. Lance DeWeese trying to better his spot down the back straightaway. He's on the outside of Jessica Zemkin and he's looking for more off the turn. One lap in, Stevie Smith, your leader. Gravel the number 2 spot. Then it's Schaefer back there in third with, right now, the 30C of Lance DeWeese in position number 4. He is closing in on Schaefer down the back straightaway. They'll swing it off the turn, this time by 2 in, 2 to go. For the number 1 is Stevie Smith. Up to the turn, he'll go, and he is pulling away from gravel off of corner number 2. Schaefer still back there for third. And then you've got the number 30C of Lance DeWeese, followed by Jessica Zemkin and the 2 of Blaney. Okay, off of turns 3 and 4 comes your race leader, Stevie Smith, and he is pulling away. And then he is followed by Gravel, Schaefer, and Lance DeWeese. And now Jessica Zemkin will watch Blaney go on by. So Blaney now moves up to position number 5. White flag being displayed for Stevie Smith. Gravel still sitting second. That might be the place to be. The outside row seems to be good on the initial starts of the events. Final time through turns number 3 and 4. And your winner will be Stevie Smith, second to David Gravel, third to Schaefer, fourth will go to Lance DeWeese, fifth to Blaney, and sixth.
We're set to turn the sportsmen's loose. 20 laps, green flag flies. And into turns 1 and 2 they go. They're 3 wide going into turns 1 and 2. Brandon Hagen, Tom Benedict, and Tommy Conklin. And Hagen and Evoy starting to slice through this field here. But up in front, Mike Arquette continues to lead the way as they work off of corners 3 and 4. It's Jenna David, Neil Provost in second and third.
The log jam continues behind the 2EZ of Mike Arquette. Mike Arquette able to get himself a little distance between him and the 2 through, I would say, 7th place car of Tom Benedict. Quite a strong field in positions 2 through 7 here, Tim, as Mike Arquette will come around to collect lap number 2.
And I'll tell you what, Mike Arquette, Jenna David are all by themselves in spots 1 and 2, but Brandon Hagen and Neil Provost at a meeting of the minds down here in the front stretch, and Provost jumps to that third spot. Thunder Anderson back there in the 4th position. Hagen rounds out your top 5. Then it's Dylan Evoy in the number 6 position.
Some good racing continues now as the 30 of Brent Kesley, number 30, as he continues to battle with the 18 of Louis Jackson, able to get around. Louis Jackson, now he's going to look for the inside of the 76 machine of Christian Smoke. Mike Arquette continues to lead.
And right now, the 30 of Thunder Anderson has a problem. He has got a right front shot off on that 30 machine. He bolts to the top side of turns 1 and 2, allowing the field to go by, and a tough break for Thunders. He was having a strong run out there, and he will take it pit side. But with 4 laps up on the scoreboard, Mike Arquette's making it look pretty easy here in the early going.
Brendan Hagen able to get by the number 2 machine of Jenna David as he came out of turns number 4. Mike Arquette, your leader. Brendan Hagen, the 12, sets his sights on him as we come around to complete lap number 6.
And 6 laps are up on the scoreboard. And Brandon Hagen, who, as I mentioned earlier, has had some strong runs here this year at Mohawk, and he dives down to the inside of Mike Arcutt, and he'll go up to the top spot as Hagen leads the field off of turn number four. It's Arcutt in second. Dylan Evoy has gotten around the 29 of Conklin to pick off third and pulls away into turn number two, and caution on the speedway.
Caution will come out for the 76X of Christian Smoke. Christian Smoke's going to take it.
It was good to see Sheldon back in the winner's circle here.
So Green comes out on the field. It is the 12 of Brendan Hagen. He is your leader. Behind him, the 83 of the Brockville Bullet, Dylan Evoy. Mike Arquette going to take it up on the high side. Correct that. Mike Arquette, he'll take the lead from the number 12 of Brendan Hagen.
And I tell you what, Mike Arquette made that look really easy. Hagen slow coming off of turn number two, allowing Arquette to get by, but Hagen will charge back around the bottom side of the speedway and get the lead once again. But look at Brent Kelsey fly on the bottom side. Kelsey has come up to play here. He's charging up underneath Arquette for the number two spot. Meanwhile, Dylan Evoy, Tom Conklin looking for room to go off of turn four.
Mike Arquette, he likes the high side. Brent Kesley says, you know what, you liked it, I'm going to try to go hide as they continue to try to run down the leader. Number 12, Brendan Hagen, they come into the turns 3 and 4. Sitting in third, it is Dylan Evoy. In fourth, Mike Arquette. And rounding out your top five is the 29 of Tom Conklin.
And right now the field's starting to space themselves out at the halfway point here. Dylan Evoy trying to close in on Brandon Hagen. Right now he's got Brent Kelsey right there in front of him. He's going to make short work of Kelsey. He'll dive down to the inside, pick off the number two spot. Kelsey charges after him in four. But right now it's Evoy, your new runner-up.
As we mentioned earlier in the heat races, three out of the last 4 weeks, it has been the 83 of Dylan Evoy. The only one able to defeat him so far in the last month has been Mother Nature. Brendan Hagen continues to lead on lap number 11.
And with Hagen leading this field into turns one and two, he'd love nothing better than to get his first ever Mohawk feature win. He said he's won pretty much at about five or six different racetracks in this sportsman car and would love nothing better than to get a win here. But right now he's got Dylan Evoy charging after him down the front straightaway.
The battle now is for the fifth position between the number two of Mike Arquette and the 29 of Tom Conklin. Conklin going to try the high side as Arquette's going to stick it to the bottom. Coming out of two, he will gain the number five position on lap number 13.
And while that battle goes on, the battle for the top spot slowly starting to take shape here as they've got the lap machine of Christian Smoke right there in front of them as Brandon Hagen leads the field down the front straightaway, this time by five laps to go. Can Dylan Evoy do anything with Hagen?
Five laps remains the issue. It is the 12 of Brendan Hagen continuing to lead. Lap traffic now. Christian Smoke's going to move to the high side to give him a little bit of room coming into 3 and 4. Dylan Evoy looking to close the gap now as he does. Coming into turns 3 and 4. Coming out of 4. Number 12, Brendan Hagen still remains your leader.
Evoy is second, followed by Brent Kelsey in the 30. Then that battle for the number 4 spot rages on back here with Tom Conklin and Mike Arquette, as Arquette, who led a couple of laps to start this one off. We got caution for Mike White in turn number 4 right in front of our leader. He spins over there.
Dylan Evoy, they both put the power to the clay as they come around to take the green from Austin Swan.
Green flag flies. Hagen gets a great restart that time. He's able to pull away from Evoy by about 2 car lengths. As they work down the back straightaway this time around, it'll be 3 laps to go, and Dylan Evoy is not done yet. He charges after Hagen down the front stretch with Kelsey Conklin and Mike Arquette in tow.
Mike Arquette rounds out your top correction. Mike Arquette now in the fourth position as he continues his strong run here this season. Dylan Evoy going to move up the track a little bit. The double sticks come out from Austin Swamp. 2 to go. Does Dylan Evoy have enough to catch Brendan Hagen?
And we shall see in the closing laps of this one down the back straightaway. That gap between your top two has stayed the same as they come off of turn number 4. White flag will be displayed this time by as Hagen leads in the white flag lap.
Hagen going to put her dead to the bottom in turns 1 and 2. Evoy back there on the bottom now as they go onto the back stretch. Evoy continues in second position. Brendan Hagen looking to pick up a win here this evening. He bobbles a bit and turns 3. Coming out of 4, Brendan Hagen wins it. In second position, it will be the 83 of Dylan Evoy. Finishing third, Brendan Hagen. And fourth, it is the 29 of... to Tim Baltz as he will interview tonight's sportsman winner, the number 12 of Brendan Hagen.
So Brian Field set, ready to go. 25 laps, the scheduled distance. They're off and running. Ryan Helm to the early lead. Roy Tarbell back there in that runner-up spot as Gardner Stone, Clayton Benedict, and now Derek Martin jumping into the top five. But here comes Tarbell with a big bid down to the inside for the lead. He'll get the top spot as they work off corner three and four.
Quite a collection of cars back in the field. Chris Rabby looking to put his way back up into the front. He's got some people to contend with as he'll try to make his way up towards the front. But in front of him, the 55 of Perry Francis. On the outside, Casey Swamp makes the move and gets around Rabby.
As they work off of turns three and four, Perry Francis starting to slice his way through the field. Winner here a couple of weeks ago as the 01 of Rabby battles behind him. Gage Moran coming up the challenge as well. He rides back there in the number eight spot with Swamp and Melvin Rush, your top 10.
So we have two laps in the book. Lap number three, Roy Tarbell, your leader. A feature winner already once this season here at the Mohawk International Raceway. Timmy O'Brien in second. And now we've got a jangle of cars in turn number two.
And a big melee over there, I believe. So green flag set to come out here next as Roy Tarbell and Timmy O'Brien lead him to the green, and Tarbell gets a great restart that time. He'll take away the top spot. Then it's O'Brien along with the 12 of Benedict and Rabby charging on the top side down the back straightaway.
Chris Rabby looking to add another victory to his already impressive season. But first, he's got to get by the 12 machine of Clayton Benedict, which he'll do on lap number five. Roy Tarbell now will give up the lead to the 88 of Timmy O'Brien.
And I believe Casey Swamp just lost a power plant going into turn one. You can see the fluid down on the racetrack, and he will pull it to the pit area. Caution flag flies.
Tough break there, Tim, for Casey Swamp, who had a pretty good run going. So, Timmy O'Brien takes the early lead on lap number five. Chris Rabby has worked his way up to the number two position as they enter turns three and four. A gaggle of cars behind him. We've got a car out of shape. Melvin Rush on the backstretch, able to power the plant back up and back underway racing.
And Larry Welling is headed pit side. Meanwhile, up in front, Rabby shoots to the top side. He goes to the number one spot in turn number three. O'Brien trying to battle back on the bottom. Gage Moran tucked right down on the bottom of the speedway along with Perry Francis. And now Kerry Terrance has made his way up into the top five as he rides fifth.
Chris Rabby looking to run away and hide here as we've got seven in the books looking to complete eight of 25. Timmy O'Brien on the outside. Coming on the inside now is the 16 of Gage Moran. Gage Moran says, I'm going to try to see what you got tonight, Chris Rabby. Here I come.
And Moran down on the inside. He'll pick off that number two spot as they work in turns three and four. O'Brien battling back on the top side. He is now third. Perry Francis is fourth, using the low line around the speedway. Terrance still completing your top five. A lot of people right now are finding that this outside groove has come into its own, and Rabby is using it very well right now as he leads coming off of turn four.
Chris Rabby continues to hit his marks lap after lap, starting to create a little more distance between him himself and the number 16 car of Gage Moran, who runs in the number two position, followed by Timmy O'Brien, Perry Francis, Clayton Benedict, and the number one machine of Gardner Stone.
As they work down the front straightaway, Rabby already starting to slice his way through lap traffic. He has gotten by Melvin Rush. Now he gets up to the back bumper of Derek Martin as Gage Moran and Timmy O'Brien will try to navigate by the Melvin Rush number six off of turn four. Rabby has a car right in front of him as Derek Martin just about got out of shape.
So Chris Rabby able to get by the 3X of Derek Martin. Gage Moran unable to close the gap on that time, but lap traffic continues to be an issue now for Chris Rabbi as he'll come up behind the M20 of Steve Miller and the 15 of Ryan Helm.
13 laps up on the scoreboard, 12 more remain, and Rabbi making it look easy out there right now as he gets by Rick Miller and in the process gets by Ryan Helm as well down the front straightaway, putting even more distance between himself and Gage Moran as the caution flag flies. Melvin Rush around in turn number two once again.
Potentially on the restart. No, he's going to duck it to the bottom and keep himself along the line with Chris Rabbi. This time he may be able to stick with him.
Field works down into turns one and two, and O'Brien tried the inside on Moran. That time couldn't quite get the job done, though. He'll settle in behind Moran in spot number three as Moran tries the outside-inside move to do everything in the books to run down Rabbi.
The key for Gage Moran at this point is to hit his marks lap after lap. Chris Rabbi has been doing so as we've got 15 in the books, 10 to go. In the third spot, it is Timmy O'Brien. In the number four spot, it is the 66X of Kerry Terrance, and Perry Francis continue to battle out for the number four position.
And Kerry Terrance has got that outside groove working. You see the left one front wheel flying in the breeze back there. He works to the outside of Perry Francis, this time coming off of turns three and four. Francis slides up in front. Terrance with a move down to the inside, and he'll pick off the fourth spot as they go into turns one and two. It's Rabbi, Moran, O'Brien, your top three, then Kerry Terrance in the 66, and a good battle for the fifth spot with Todd Stone and Perry Francis.
Todd Stone going to dip it to the low side. Perry Francis going to stick to the high side. Cannot make it work. Todd Stone will come around and collect the position. Chris Rabbi continues to lead, seven laps to go for this 25-lap feature event this evening for the 358 Modifieds.
And Rabbi making it look very easy right now as he works in turns one and two with a huge lead on Gage Moran, who rides in second. Now Kerry Terrance and Timmy O'Brien going at it for the number three spot as O'Brien starting to fade here in the closing laps. Todd Stone now completing the top five. Perry Francis starting to fall just a little bit behind Todd Stone as a battle for sixth and seventh goes on between Sykes and John Lazor.
As we see now, a few more black marks being put down on the racing surface. A little more tire if you will. That'll create some great racing conditions for the sprints that are up next. Four laps remains to be the issue. Rabbi remains the leader.
As they work in turns one and two and down the back straightaway, it's been the Chris Rabbi show for the good portion of this event as he leads the field one more time down off of turn number four. Three laps left to decide it. Gage Moran has the second spot as O'Brien got out of shape and he loses two spots to Kerry Terrance, and now Todd Stone back up into the fourth spot with two laps to go.
Two laps remains the issue. Can Chris Rabbi hang on as he's starting to hide himself into lap traffic? Gage Moran rides around in the number two position. Behind him, the 66X of Kerry Terrance, who has had a very, very strong run here this evening.
White flag will be displayed this time by, and Chris Rabbi is on this field tonight as he works into turn one and two this time by, with nobody behind him and nobody in front of him. Checkered flag will be out this time by as he heads through turns three and four. Two in a row and fourth of the season for Chris Rabbi. Second spot will go to Kerry Terrance, and a great drive for Kerry. Gage Moran, Todd Stone, and Timmy O'Brien will get the number five spot. Check one, two, there we go. That's what happens. You just have to twist a couple of knobs on there. Win number four of the season for Rabbi and sixth overall. Of course, as I mentioned last year, everybody knows what he did in the sportsman ranks. 15 wins here, 31 on the year, along with two track titles. Third in the Mr. Dirt Car Sportsman standings last season as well. And in a moment, we'll jump in and get a quick word with him. And the good people from Ellis Automotive will make the trophy presentation. And here he
is out of the car for the fourth time this season, his second week in a row. How about a round of applause for the 0-1 of Chris Rabby? Another dominant win. I'll tell you what, it just seems like this place caters your driving style, doesn't it?
I don't know what it is about this place, but I tell you what, it's pretty easy to drive the car when you're driving on the top side or the bottom side, and the thing just handles awesome. So it's hats off to our whole team. You know, I mean, it's a 30-guy program, and everyone contributes.
Absolutely. And, of course, you know, there's a lot of bites still left on this racetrack. Were you surprised with the sprint cars being here that there's not as much rubber laid down?
Yeah, the track was a little bit slicker than it usually is, but I find this track really gets patchy, and you just got to hit the patches and try to capitalize early before the tires neutralize on these cars. And once the air pressure builds up, you know, they fall off in a hurry.
Of course, it's your fourth win of the season, second week in a row that you've been to victory lane. Could it get any better than this, really?
I don't know. The season's going pretty good over here. We've had fast race cars over at Cornwall, just bad luck, so I'd like to get a win there pretty soon.
Absolutely. Anybody want to thank real quick?
I got to thank all my sponsors. You know, the Francis brothers for the race car, and Bug Oaks and his family, you know, put the motors in the car. PJ Peters, you know, his family's got a race car back in the shop as well. So it's a team effort, and I got to thank all my crew guys and all the help I get for sure.
Absolutely, and well, congratulations, Chris. We'll see you down front again for sure.
Right. Pull out of turn two, they begin to assemble in rows of four. This is our way of thanking you, the fan, for support here tonight at the Mohawk International Raceway. In return, we ask the fans stand and show your appreciation to these 16 drivers as they battle it out in tonight's main event for $5,000. As they come around in the famous four-breast parade lap, we promise you this is a sight you will not soon forget. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the 2011 All-Star Circuit of Champions. Again, your starting lineup looks like this on the front row. A main event, they'll go green this time off of turn number four. Austin Swamp, chief starter here at the Mohawk International Raceway. He's got the green flag in his hand. Stevie Smith, David Gravel, they'll bring him down into turn number four. Green is out and we are underway. Field charges up into turns number one and two. And Smith's gonna take the top spot as he slides up in front of Gravel on the back straightaway. Down into turns number three and four. Lance DeWeese making a move on the outside. DeWeese side by side with Schaefer through the corner. DeWeese now on the top side. Schaefer down low. They'll stay alongside as they race up into turns number one and two. Schaefer going to try to pull the slider, but DeWeese right there. Down the backstretch they'll race. DeWeese has got that number three spot in hand. That'll put Schaefer back to the number four spot. Stevie Smith, he'll show the way in the number one. Second right now is still David Gravel. Third is now Lance DeWeese. And that puts Schaefer back to fourth. Fifth right now, Jessica Zemkin. Sixth, Del Blaney. Seventh, Darren Pittman. Eighth is Justin Barger. He battles with Cap Henry on the back straightaway. Cap Henry shoots down on the inside. Barger, meanwhile, he'll switch lanes now. He'll go low as Henry comes off the top side. And Henry will have that spot as they race down to the line. Three laps are in. Still 27 remain. Your race leader continues to be the number one is Stevie Smith. And now lap traffic a factor here with four laps complete. As Smith had to take evasive action to get by the Ide number two. Now he'll go by the other Ide, Mark Ide, down the back straightaway into position number one. He'll hold. Now the 89G of Gravel working the top side, closing in, as is DeWeese and Schaefer. Still riding back there in fifth. That's Jessica Zemkin. Now Blaney is elected to move to the high side with the number two, so he'll look to close in on Jay-Z on the back straightaway. Blaney clears Ide down the backstretch. He's still got a bunch of ground to make up on Zemkin as they all work the high side through corners number three and four. Your leader, Stevie Smith, about five car lengths now, the differential between himself and David Gravel. And now Gravel bobbles off of turn number two, and Lance DeWeese begins the close. Lance DeWeese out of Fayetteville, Pennsylvania, up to the backside of Gravel as they bring it off of turn number four and continue down the home straightaway into one and two. Gravel, a little bit different line this time, way up on that outside. Stevie Smith, meanwhile, puts Miller down a lap as they race into corner number three, and he'll be forced to work the inside lane. Now he'll shoot back across. He'll catch the cushion. Gravel was not there, was not able to take advantage. So now Gravel dive bombs Pete Miller going up into turns number one and two. Lance DeWeese, meanwhile, now he has got to deal with Miller on the back straightaway. He'll shoot by on the outside. He'll maintain position number three. Into corners number three and four. Second, third, and fourth spots now right together as Schaefer on the back bumper of Lance DeWeese. into one and two. Super going to go down a lap as well down the backstretch. Stevie Smith still shows the way with the number one. Second is David Gravel. Third, Lance DeWeese. Fourth, Tim Schaefer. Fifth, Jessica Zemkin. Sixth and closing is Dale Blaney. Seventh right now is Darren Pittman. And that's the way they come off of turn four, come down the line with 10 laps complete. So 10 laps are in. Justin Barger and Deidre going a lap down now as Stevie Smith gains on him into turn number three. Smith going to elect to go to the inside. Gravel working it up on the outside. Off the turn, 11 laps complete. And we've got a battle for the top spot shaping up here with 11 complete. Smith goes high. Here goes Gravel on the outside. Down the backstretch, new leader is David Gravel. So David Gravel now takes the top spot, and he'll pull the slider on Justin Barger. Off of corner number four, new leader, David Gravel. So using that high side, Stevie Smith got bottled up in traffic, and now on the move, here comes Tim Schaefer. Schaefer side by side with Smith down the backstretch. Wing to wing, they'll take it into turn number three, and now Schaefer into the second spot. So Tim Schaefer on the move as he just drove by Stevie Smith. Lance DeWeese is still there. Again, Lance DeWeese came into the night, the East Region point leader, and right now he is in front of his closest competition, running back there in position number seven. That is Darren Pittman. Now Justin Barger off the pace. Barger in the 32, going to take his ride pit side, and we stay green. 14 are in. Next time by, we will be halfway through this A main event. It is all David Gravel out in front. Tim Schaefer still there for second. Stevie Smith, Lance DeWeese, and Jessica Zemkin, your top five. Everybody working the outside lane right now. So far, so good for David Gravel as he looks to close in and put another lap on the 24K of Devin Carone. Carone drifts up to the cushion, Gravel up on the inside, couldn't quite complete that pass, and all the while, Tim Schaefer begins to close. Carone gets up out of the groove, goes up above that cushion. Now Smith shoots underneath, nearly makes contact there on the back straightaway, and Lance DeWeese closing in. Lance DeWeese looking for the number three spot as Smith slides up in front of Carone. And now Lance had to get on the binders, nearly got into the backside of Devin Carone, that time over through turns number three and four. Down the back straightaway, George Super, great in front of your race leader, David Gravel. Gravel on the binders a little bit here on the outside. Now he'll have to switch lanes and look down low. Here comes Schaefer on the top side. Schaefer looking for the lead, nearly get together. Schaefer gets pushed off the racetrack. Stevie Smith goes back to the number two spot. And now he is on the back bumper of David Gravel into turn number three. Gravel going to go up and slide in front of George Suprick. Stevie Smith going to try to do the different move. He's going to try to come underneath Suprick. He'll do so here on the home stretch. Schaefer, he is going to lose a bunch of ground with the number 83 ride as we continue on here down the back straightaway. So it's David Gravel, your race leader, followed by Stevie Smith, Tim Schaefer, Lance DeWeese, and Jessica Zemkin, still your top five. This time by 20 laps complete. And 10 laps remain. And so far, so good for David Gravel. But again, Stevie Smith knocking on the door. Smith following him on the top side, as is Tim Schaefer. And Schaefer really now making up some ground. He has got a fast race car, but does he have time to get back to your top two? Along the back straightaway, Gravel opens up the edge right now over Stevie Smith. As Smith continues to pound that cushion, hasn't been able to move around, has not looked for a different way by. He's been utilizing the high side, as is Gravel and Schaefer and Lance DeWeese. Meanwhile, Jessica Zemkin, she rides back there in the number five spot. Now up to sixth is Darren Pittman, seventh Dale Blaney, and eighth right now on the grid is Danny Holgraver in the number D4. So that's the way we run. Again, 23 are in, seven laps remain. Side by side goes Gravel with Devin Carone, and that's the race for the lead. Here comes Stevie Smith on the inside. Smith now back to the top spot. So Stevie Smith using lap traffic, the old pick and roll down low off of turn number two. He'll take the lead here on lap number 24. So Smith now into the top side. The top spot, he'll go back to the outside, and he is driving away now from Gravel. As now Schaefer shoots down low, and Tim Schaefer now back into position number two. So Schaefer back up to second here as we work our way with five laps to go. So 25 are in, five to go. Can Stevie Smith hold on? Schaefer, though, working the outside. Lap traffic will be a factor in this one as they race down into corners number three and four. Stevie Smith stays up on the outside, as does Schaefer. Lance DeWeese now working over David Gravel. Lance DeWeese, he went to the inside lane, looked to see if he could find something over in turns three and four, couldn't quite get it done, so now he'll have to regroup and try one more time. As they race through corners number three and four, Tim Schaefer just puts the old slider on Pete Miller as they put another lap on him. 27 are in, three to go, and now Stevie Smith in severe lap traffic off the corner and down the back straightaway. Cap Henry in front of him, as is Suprick, as they race into turn three, now off of corner number four. Here comes Schaefer. How's it going to get done here? We've got two to go. Smith going to pull a slider into turn number one. Super gets on the binders. That allows Smith to get by. Now Schaefer on the outside. He is bottled in behind Cap Henry and George Super. He'll go three wide through the turn. So Tim Schaefer making some moves here. going three wide to get through traffic, but this is it. Last opportunity to get it done. Off the turn, down the back straightaway. Final time goes Stevie Smith into turn number three. Now into corner number four. Off the turn, picking up the victory, Stevie Smith. Second will go to Tim Schaefer. Third at the line will go to David Gravel. Fourth to Lance DeWeese. And fifth to Darren Pittman. Sixth, Jessica Zemkin. Seventh will be Dale Blaney. And eighth on the good will go to the D4 of Danny Holtgraver.
Well, he's making his way out here. Your feature winner, the Zemco Headers, number one machine of Stevie Smith. Getting some congratulations down here in Victory Lane. Already got the helmet off. Taking the seatbelts off now. Ladies and gentlemen, he's out of the car. Put your hands together for your O'Reilly All-Star Circuit of Champions feature winner, Stevie Smith. Get him over here, get a word with him. Well, Stevie, heck of a job. Congratulations. Tell you what, that one did not come easy.
No, well, we're leading the race, and I'm trying to keep from, getting tore up or crashing, and then those guys are all racing hard behind me, and they make a move. So when I went back to third, I just did the same thing, ran as hard as I could and went the opposite way. And I hate to back up first to win it, but it worked out.
How important is this win for your team?
Well, it's very important. We've had a long season so far, and I got to tell these guys, they work very hard, and I'm glad we're sticking it out here, and I think we've got things turned around. We got a little better last in Canada, the last show there, and it seemed to carry on to this race. So I can't say enough for these guys. This is our third year together, and I look forward for more to come.
Now, we mentioned traffic there. How important was it there that when you got back to the lead to make that move on the inside? Did he leave the door open, or did you just know it was going to stick down there?
Well, I went in up high and then turned and came across. I think I tried to roll in under him before, and that's when I got past. So this time I just waited, followed the lap car, and then turned under. And Gravel was just sliding up a little bit, kind of like I did when I was leading, and I just got on the bottom and beat him off the corner.
Race fans, let's give a hand. Your feature winner here this evening, driver the number one, Stevie Smith.
In the battle of the pace vehicles. But right now, it's the battle of the pro stocks. Last week's winner, the Bulldog, Dave Bissonette, sets the pace as the green comes out.
It'll be Rocco Ben running in second, looking to get back into victory lane as he's battling the Bulldog. The Bulldog looking to make it two in a row here as there's quite a cluster of cars behind him that say, you know what, I'd like to see you in victory lane.
And Jody Swamp, Stefan LeBrun, Dion Oaks are having quite the tussle out there for third, fourth, and fifth. Jody Lattiser around the top side of those two, and he'll pick off that fifth spot. P.J. Peters right behind him along with the 188 of David Papineau. Up in front, though, Dave Bissonette picking up where he left off last week with that brand-new ride, and he says that crate motor in that car definitely helps out because of the weight difference in that 47 machine, and he's using it to his advantage here at lap two.
The one to watch is the 48 of Dion Oaks, who is rejoining us, as now the yellow is going to come out for Ricky Thompson, who parked it up by the
rain. Leave us alone for a while so we can get a good smooth surface in, and that definitely helps out for sure.
So it'll be the Bulldog taking the green flag here as they come around going into lap number three. On the outside, Rocco Ben, and the inside, it is the 48 of Dion Oaks, who's going to make his move, coming into three on the back bumper of Dave Bissonette.
Into turns three and four. And Bissonette still holding the top spot, but the battle is going on for that runner-up spot. Dion Oaks has got his hands full with Rocco Ben and Jody Swamp. And there's Joey Lattiser into this mix as well. Stefan LeBrun in the number six is with him in sixth, followed by Dave Papineau in seventh. The 18 of Jackson is eighth. Ninth to P.J. Peters. Tenth right now is Rod Tarbell.
Jody Swamp, the 69 car, ran out of a little bit of real estate as he came into four. He bumped a rubber tire there. But now back on the outside, it'd be Rocco Ben. On the inside, Jody Swamp coming into three. There's company. There's Joey Lattiser looking to make a race out of this with four in the books.
And Lattiser just taking his time, pacing himself through this field. As they work in lap number five right now, your top two drivers have started to put a little distance between themselves in that battle from third on back as Jody Swamp leads that parade into turn number three with Joey Lannister in fourth. And now Rock Obey is starting to lose more spots. He's got Louis Jackson to his inside, and he'll pick off fifth.
You watch, folks, and Tim, watch the bite Dave the Bulldog Bissonette gets coming out of two, as well as Dion Oaks. They're able to gain some more precious ground, but yet continuing behind them, the 69 of Jody Swamp, the 92 of Joey Lattisour, and the 18 of Louis Jackson, rounding out your top five as we complete lap number six.
As they work down the back straightaway this time, the 48 of Dion Oaks is trying to chase down the number 47 of Bissonette. As he works in turns three and four, Jody Swamp holding down position number three. Then it is the battle for that number four spot as the 18 of Jackson down to the inside of Joey Lannister. We haven't seen this too much over the last few seasons as Jackson puts the power down to the ground and draws alongside of Lannister into turn three.
Louis Jackson going to take it to the low side. Joey Lannister to the high side as they battle for the fourth position. Louis Jackson on the bottom. He'll come around in the fourth position on lap number nine.
As they work down the backstretch, it's all Dave Bissonette right now, looking to become the second two-time winner of this season. Ricky Thompson, the only two-time winner with the first two events of the year. But Dion Oaks, Jody Swamp may have something to say about this before this race is over. We're halfway home.
Back in the field, the 73 of P.J. Peters continues to battle with the four of Rock Oben. As lap after lap, side by each, wheel to wheel, they continue to battle. P.J. Peters starting to gain a little more ground on Rock as he will take over the position.
Down the front straightaway, they hustle one more time, and Louis Jackson is a man possessed out there. He got alongside of Joey Lannister about a lap ago, and now he draws alongside of Jody Swamp and gets by Jody for that number three position. And Swamp and Lannister definitely losing some spots out there as Jackson is coming to the front in a hurry.
Joey Lattiser going to take it to the high side, coming into turns one and two. Jody Swamp's going to duck down to the bottom. He's going to follow Louis Jackson, Dion Oaks, and your race leader, Dave the Bulldog Bissonette.
And Bissonette settles into turns three and four. He's got a comfortable lead, but that 18 of Jackson is flying on the top side of the speedway. Made a lot of his passes on the bottom, but he has moved upstairs trying to find some more bite, as has Joey Lannister in that 92 machine as he works on the back bumper of Jody Swamp down the back straightaway this time into turns three and four. Bissonette right there in that number one spot along with Dion Oaks in second, but the battle is for third on back as we've got Jackson, Swamp, and Lannister, three-car battle for third.
Dave the Bulldog Bissonette enjoying this as the positions 2, 3, 4, and 5 continue to battle it out behind them as they come into turns 3 and 4. On the outside, Louis Jackson looking. On the inside, it is Jody Swamp holding his line. Joey Lattiser following closely behind.
Field working into turns 1 and 2 this time. Five more laps remain, and the 18 of Louis Jackson along with the 92 of Joey Lattiser having it out for fourth and fifth. Meanwhile, the 18 of Jackson jumps to the top side of the speedway this time, and he'll get by the 69 of Swamp one more time as we head into one and two.
Four laps the remaining distance for your Pro Stocks. Dave the Bulldog Bissonette continues to lead the race, and the battle continues for the spots 3, 4, and five. Joey Lattiser looking to go a little high this time. Can he split the difference between Jody Swamp and Louis Jackson? He cannot make the pass as they come around to complete lap number 16.
Three laps left to go as Bissonette working in that number one spot. If he had a rear view mirror in that car, he'd love what he's seeing right now as Dion Oaks and Jody Swamp along with Louis Jackson and Joey Lannister are having quite the tussle from second on back.
Now, Dion Oaks will keep it to the bottom side. Louis Jackson going to the high side on turn two, looking to get around Dion Oaks and possibly run down Dave Bissonette with two laps to go. Look at the battle for 2, 3, 4, and 5 positions. Joey Lattiser on the high side. I will take it on home from here. One lap, the remaining distance, the white hanky is displayed. Dave the Bulldog Bissonette takes it out of two. He continues to lead. Now it's Louis Jackson on the outside of Dion Oaks as they enter turns three and four. Jody Swamp, Joey Lattiser continue to battle for positions 4 and 5. You're a winner for the second week in a row, Dave the Bulldog Bissonette. Finishing in the Second position, Dion Oaks. Louis Jackson in third, Joey Latisore in the fourth position, and finishing, rounding out your top five is the 69. Let's take it to pit side for Tim Baltz with tonight's Pro Stock winner.
And obviously second of the season. And there he is out of the car for the second time in as many weeks, the Bulldog Dave Bissonnette. Jump in real quick and get a quick word with him. And well, we did this last week and never thought he was going to get back to victory lane here at Mohawk, but Dave, you've done this 2 weeks in a row now, and boy, I tell you what, you had a great car.
I got to start with my pit crew guys. You can't believe the work that we did in the pit. We changed a clutch, pressure plate, everything in this between the two races to get me out here for the feature, because I owe it all to them guys. If it wasn't for them, I would not be here racing and having a good time. Unfortunate that Morgan had some bad luck in a blowout, but he's okay. So we'll be back with the two cars very shortly.
Looks like he's got a little bit of a limp to him, but he looks like he's doing okay over there. Once again, this track, it seemed like he came into his own. There seemed to be quite a bit of bite still left in it.
Yes, if you stayed right tight to the bottom, and we made an adjustment on the car, hoping for that, and it did work out. And I was just talking to our flagman, and he was saying they were battling in the back, which saved me out in the front. When you're in fresh air, you can fly here, but if you're battling, it's hard, and you're not picking the line you want to pick, and we go from there.
And the starting position definitely helped too, for sure.
Yeah, so I'm not used to this starting on the front row here at Frogtown. Obviously, that shows that we're not doing very well. We're low in the points. But, hey, we're going to take the wins because it's been a while.
Obviously, two wins in a row. Congratulations, Dave. Let's see down the front again, maybe.
I hope so.
All righty. Win number two in a row for the Bulldog, Dave Bissonnette.
Derek Colbert looking to follow him. The green is displayed. Nolan Swamp breaks away to an early lead. Colbert in second. Owen White in third. Ernie Cree in fourth. And Corey Castell round out your top five as they head out of turns one and two. Side by each, two by two as they come into turns three and four.
And Nolan Swamp around in front of the whole field continues on, but he's got a flat on the right rear. So the caution flag will be displayed here.
So Ernie Cree looking to take the green. On the outside of him, this 79 to Derek Colbert. Derek Colbert will take the green flag as they come around into turns one and two.
And as they work off of turn number two this time, you see John Green on that outside groove. He gets alongside of Owen White into turns three and four. Darrell Mitchell completes the top five along with Trevor Gauthier and Corey Castell. Up in front, though, last week's winner, Ernie Cree, is breathing down the neck of that 79 of Colbert as they work off of turn one and two.
Now, Colbert was not with us last week, but he's come back. He's prepared to get himself into victory lane as Ernie Cree is going to take the lead coming out of two. Now in second, it is Derek Colbert. In third, Owen White. And in fourth, the 22 of John Green. Quite a battle now between the top three, Tim, as we come around to complete lap number three.
Lap three is up on the board, and Ernie Cree, who's got four wins in six races over at Cornwall, he finally got to victory lane here last week and is picking up where he left off last Friday night right here at Mohawk in the number one spot. Derek Colbert back there in the runner-up position. Then it's Owen White, John Green, and Darrell Mitchell right there, your fast five.
Darrell Mitchell starting to pick up the pace as this race goes on. Great job there by the one of Nolan Swamp's pit crew to get him back onto the track for the feature. Your leader continues to be the 18 of Ernie Cree. Now Owen White going to dip to the inside going into turn two. He's going to get to the inside of Derek Colbert as they come around to complete lap number four. It'll be Ernie Cree, your leader.
Down into turns one and two, Ernie Cree has the top spot all to himself as they get around the lap machine of Randy Whiting. Down the back straightaway they go. Owen White looking to close in. Owen's won twice this year. The only driver in the Bandits to do so. Derek Colbert does have a win as well in that number three spot, along with John Green in the 22. Then Daryl Mitchell in the 37. As we're halfway through this one, six more remain.
Halfway through, you are correct, Tim. As it is, Owen White starting to gain a little clay now on Ernie Cree, the leader. As we are halfway through, Derek Colbert rides in third. Now, the gap is starting to close a little bit more for Owen White. He's going to try it on the inside as they come around for lap seven. It's still Ernie Cree, your leader.
And Ernie is trying to fend off those challenges as they work in turns one and two. And they trade a little paint going into turn number two. Nolan Swamp is around in turn two, Randon. Earlier this season, back on June the 10th. Owen White, as I mentioned earlier, the only repeat winner. We may have another repeat winner as the green comes out. Ernie Cree has the lead and a little bit of bumper tag on the front stretch. Almost stack him up and count him into one, and Ernie Cree with a problem.
Owen White giving him the front bumper to let him know he was there. Now Cree with the problem as he's going to lose at least three positions. John Green in second, Derek Colbert in third, Ernie Cree in fourth. And it'll be John Green coming around on the inside on turn number four to take the lead away from Owen White.
Just four laps remaining, and the 22 of John Green, who hasn't won since the CKON 97.3 FM Bandit Series race a few weeks ago, has got the top spot. Now they're three wide going into turn number four. Derek Colbert loses out on that battle, unfortunately, and he slows in turn number four. Gets it going again, but I tell you what, Brian, he lost a lot of ground to the leaders now.
Some very, very tight racing going on here this evening. Now, Ernie Cree is going to set his sights on the 22 of John Green. Going to come into the high side in turns three. Owen White going to look to the inside between turns three and four. No real estate for him, but Ernie Cree says, look at me, I'm to the bottom, mama.
Two laps to go, and Ernie Cree, despite that little bobble on the restart, has gotten back to the top spot. John Green is right there with him, though. Owen White not about to back down. He is in the third spot in closing. Daryl Mitchell is fourth, and it's Trevor Gaucher rounding out your top five, and a good debut for him out there. White flag flies in the air.
Your top three, Ernie Cree, Owen White, John Green, one lap the remaining distance here now. Owen White going to set his sights on Ernie Cree coming out of turn two. Ernie Cree starting to pick up the pace a little bit as he'll head into turns three and four. Owen White going to look for something on the inside, possibly to close the gap. He closes a little bit, but coming out of four, Ernie Cree looking to make it two in a row. Yes, sir. It's two in a row for Ernie Cree.
Owen White will get the runner-up spot. John Green in third. Daryl, along with a regular car to modifieds, pro stock, sportsman, semi-pros, and mini stocks, all brought to you by Go Glass. And Ernie Cree has made his way to victory lane, and so has Brian Page. Brian, it's all yours.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Tim Baltz. Down here in victory lane, two in a row for the 18 of Ernie Cree. He's found victory lane now twice in a row here at the Mohawk International Raceway. We'll be in here to get a few quick words with Ernie. Well, Ernie, congratulations on two in a row here. Take me back to that restart. Owen Hearn got onto your back bumper a little bit. Did you get a little nervous knowing that the great Intimidator was behind you on that one?
I'm known for missing the restarts when it's time to shift. I don't know what I was thinking. I knew Owen was there, and you can't give him an inch. And I knew I had to start in second, shift to third. So I went from second to around back
fourth.
Yeah, and I found third gear, and then I was gone.
Well, you did a great job making up a lot of real estate in the last few laps. Some people you want to thank tonight, Ernie?
All my sponsors, my dad, Mike Gaucher. He helped me the other night when I needed a hand. My wife, who held the kids while I was busy in the garage. It's hard.
Well, Ernie Cree takes family to make a racing family go. So thank you very much, Ernie, for your